This is Lizard Crate. So if you wanted to know what this is, it's this. And after I unzipped the thing, I realized that it was called Schlocking Stocking, where my segment last week that I had come up with was Christmas Schlocking Stuffers. So, you know, I was a little off. I thought maybe I was really clever, but someone else kind of came up with it before I did. Whatever. So, yeah, it's just some good games. It's bootlegs, indie games. There's going to be some Christmas-themed things in here and all kinds of other stuff. So, this isn't trash. If it says trash, you know, you'll know it's trash when it says trash. This is games plus demos, so to speak. Vinny, opinion on cash as a Christmas gift. Excellent. What do we start with? How about unique indie games? Let's try a Chimney Presents. So volume can always be an issue here, so just keep your volume kind of low, or keep your mouse or your hand by your volume, just in case things get really loud. Are you still speaking? Is this music or is this Santa speaking? Hey, Scrumpus. It's lovely to meet you. My name is Santa Claus. Can you help me out? I need to deliver these presents to all the chimneys in town, and I can't do it all by myself. So what do you say? Will you help me? You're not answering. Can you hear me? Okay, I'll tell you what. Just pretend that you said yes. Let's get started. This is our first stop. I think there's a chimney off to the right. Use the arrow keys and spacebar to move around, pop a present in the chimney, and then head to the sleigh to move on. These are houses? Huh. Sometimes there's lots of chimneys to fill. You can see how many remaining presents there are on the top left corner. We shouldn't go back to the sleigh until they're all sorted. So it's just a little platformer. It's just a little Santa platformer. Great work so far, Scrumpus. I can already tell we're going to make a great team. When does Santa turn into a demon? It looks like someone's put up some holly. I'm allergic to holly. Did you know that? Like, really allergic. One touch and I'm a mess. So let's just jump over it, okay? You would think maybe Santa would put a memo in the chimneys. Hey, next year, could you not put that shit up? Seriously. Maybe some kind of PSA on network television? I know what this is. This is the beginning. Oh shit. Santa just straight up dies. Christmas is over. That's an allergy. That feels unholy. Unholy. So wait a minute. The presents are blocking the chimneys. So where's the smoke gonna go? Fucking... The houses are gonna fill with smoke, and the kids are gonna die. That's not okay. This isn't Christmas. This is murder. He's just dropping pornos. That's basically what's happening here. It's the subtext. There's pornos going in the chimneys from the roof. The Temple of Poon, which I hope none of you have looked up. I guess this is a house? Those icicles hanging from the ceiling, they don't look too sturdy. I have a hunch that they might fall off if I get too close, so be careful. I know you'll take good care of me! Oh yeah. Yeah, I got you, Santa. The Temple of Poon. You're okay, well, you need to see this then, because I ended my stream the other night with this. I went to go look for the Orville show, like a week and a half ago, and this is an actual screenshot that I took, which doesn't appear to be the case anymore, but somehow T5HE Orville equals the Temple of Poon. Insatiable sexual frenzies, you say. Hmm. I saw an Indiana Jones porno spelled as In Diana Jones. Do you get it? God help us all. Risk it. But what the fuck are these houses? Are they supposed to be houses anymore, or did we just give up on that? There's no more continuity. Oh man, you know what? I should play a Christmas song for you guys that I think you would love after this. So, okay, I do have one more Christmas song this here holiday season that I think, you know, many of you haven't heard, and you'll treasure it as much as I do, for sure. Some of you heard it earlier today. Okay, I'm gonna stop playing this game in just a sec, because it's getting kind of repetitive and... Oh, it's almost like... We're getting a little Meat Boy-ish. Not really. It's quite a bit more manageable than Meat Boy, but... Oh! It's fun. It's a fun little platformer. Definitely didn't expect to be playing it this long. It's pretty good. Ah, there's one last present that has to be delivered. Well, the truth is, I never really needed your help delivering the presents. I've been doing this gig for a while now, after all. It's kind of my thing. But I thought you might like the adventure, so I invited you along. I hope you had a good time, even if you didn't say very much. I know I certainly did. Anyway, like I was saying, there's one last present to deliver. I'll have to deliver this one myself. To Scrumpus from Daniel. Who's Daniel? I don't know what Daniel. I know Dan, Nikki, your Bobbies. It's the spirit of the holiday, wouldn't you agree? Daniel probably developed the game. Now, I want to just share a song. A little Christmas song. It's a good one. You like them Koopa kids? They sing really well. Yeah. Merry Christmas. Yeah, it's a song. I mean, you just heard it. It's a song. Continuing on. Okay, some of these are ROM hacks, which Nintendo, please do not kill. Did you know that Oogtar is rat goo backwards? Crazy, right? Mental, even. Okay, let me get everything set up here. It shouldn't take more than a minute, and then we'll get going. So this is, I should probably have the other one open too, just in case. I have a couple of different emulators I can use for this. Okay, so like this is Super Mario 64 Operation Christmas. If it works. Or not. Okay.
It's me, Mario.
We got that far this time. Probably should have included the exact emulator in this one. Hang on.
It's me.
Nope.
It's me, Mario.
Mario is trying so hard to log in. BizHawk? Okay, it's not working with BizHawk. Yeah, this is like, you know, you got to make sure I get like a kind of a guide or something next time, you know. Change the rendering engine. Where's that? Got more technical problems. It's like yesterday all over again. Increase memory cache. Again, I don't know where these options are. I'm looking for them. Config, display, eight megabytes of RAM. Okay, hang on a minute. Well, where do I do that? In BizHawk. You can come back in like 10 minutes, everybody. This will all be fixed. Christmas song while we wait. What is this? Oh God, what is this?
It's me, Mario.
Butler is gone, but Kevin is there. Let's visit him.
Vinny, half your audience is drunk. Don't worry about it. Okay, expansion pack didn't work. So I'm looking for the other option. How do I get 8 megabytes of RAM?
In Spanish, they say,
Navidad, Feliz Navidad this Christmas.
Okay. You know, I'm good. What's this? Worst Christmas song ever. I think we just heard it. Which BizHawk are you using? I guess I'm using an older one. Oh boy. Well, this isn't that bad. This is, like, tolerable. Why am I listening to this, though? Oh. Oh, now it's pretty bad. Alright, I got a different thing I'm gonna try here. Exception. Doesn't work. Yeah! Alright. More fun than anyone could have predicted here on Vine Sauce, as usual. Okay, I'm gonna try to increase the graphics on level 3. Give me a second. This is awful. This Christmas song and everything that's happening right now. Fuck. Fatal exception stopping emulation. Okay. Are these splorts? No, it's not really working out so well. I'm gonna, Nary, I'll just, PJ64. I did try PJ64, it crashes. So we're not gonna do this one, Mario 64 Operation Christmas. That's a shame. Please, just anything that can stop that. That's great. Let's just do Link Man. Whatever the fuck this is. Oh, wow. This exists? Just watched the Mega Man cartoon today, too. Oh, look, he shoots swords. Why wouldn't he? Only two at a time, though. That is a very, very dopey face that Link has. Why is he like a fucking, like a Weeble? So you get two swords at a time. This is not like Mega Man, and it's not like Zelda. This is some weird fucking hellish middle ground between the two games, and it's making me very uncomfortable. So how about that level design? Yeah. Look at all that. All that level design. So much work was put into it. And are you a Zelda reference? Alright. I'll try a couple of levels. It's no Mario Christmas game, but, you know, it's what it is. Kinda was hoping for some Ocarina of Time music. Death Mountain Crater looks like someone with their legs- never mind. Let's go to Parappa Palace, just like in Zelda 2. That was Shrek? That was supposed to be Shrek? There's some Zelda-looking stuff. Kinda. I mean, it's almost Zelda-y. So yeah, Proto Man is apparently Shrek, even though it's clearly not the case. I don't know what Shrek has to do with Zelda, but... Man, am I loving this. Go, 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 good, yes. Oh, it's Sheik! Why am I fighting Sheik? You know what? I like Shrek better. I'm fighting Shrek. I think someone in chat said Shrek, and I read that, everyone else said Sheik. My bad. Oogtar is rat porn backwards. Where else? Gerudo Valley? Holy shit. Holy shit! That's a Hinox? Alright. Man, you can't do Gerudo Valley without the music. However, now it's a little bit better. It's kinda cool. I'd give this a kinda cool out of 10. Sporadically interesting, as internet superstar Rick Stevens once said. Oh, okay. Let's move on. I'm gonna stick in the ROM hacks area for a little bit. The name of this is The Legend of Iowa. It's the wrong renderer. Man, I'm having a lot of luck with these. Seriously, having so much luck streaming tonight. I'm no closer to learning The Legend of Iowa. All right, finally. One more time. Please give me more glitches. Give me more technical problems. One more time, please. The Legend of Iowa. The Iowa legislature passed a law banning OTC sales of Sudafed. Fearing their meth trade would crash, area gangs raided every pharmacy in the state. Now Farmer Bob can't get any relief for his cold. He must find the 8 meth labs hidden over the land, reclaim the Sudafed, and then go to the governor and end all this bullshit. Grind up the Sudafed into fine powder. Holy shit. I don't... Wow. Hang on a minute. Jeez, that's a lot of information. That is certainly a lot of information. Very specific information. Very specific information indeed. If you're gonna tangle with meth heads, you'd better take your pitchfork. Turns out a ROM hack tells you how to make a meth lab. This is just another step closer to becoming Walter White. It's fine. It's all part of it. Hey, cuckoos. It's poor cuckoos. How about them hawks? If I was from Iowa, this would be so much better. Vinny, I live in Iowa. It's exactly like this. Wasn't Iowa the birthplace of Captain James T. Kirk? Or won't it be, eventually? So that's a positive. You know, there's a fictional character is going to be born there. Just killing poor, like, woodland creatures and like, innocent, pathetic animals. Well, I mean, it's Zelda 1, but there's new levels. Wow. The hearts are Iowa. Must have really run out of things to put in this. I think this is supposed to be a meth lab. Good. Are those prostitutes? By chance? Topless prostitutes in a video game? Is that what that was? Ah, yep. It's a whorehouse. And this is Darude Sandstorm. Good. Yep, epilepsy. There you go. Just when you thought it was safe to open your eyes because it's not corruptions. What a good collection. Already. And I bet the Mario one was really good, too. I really want to play the Mario one. And there it is. I want to die. It's Christmas Day and I want to die. Very good. Very good ROM hack to make me feel that way. I think Vinny, I emailed you my emulator, which has the Mario game working. Thank you, 56 Bagels. I'll try that out in a bit. I'm gonna, like, cautiously move on to the next one. Okay, Elizarin, what the fuck, man? What are you doing? Dishonor my father. This is Christmas? Wow. I'm stunned. The main Christmas games are indie games. Okay. Please be a little bit more discerning before sending me stuff, because, like, I don't need people learning how to make meth from my streams. That would be the best thing to avoid. Princess Adventure. This one looks okay. Present Panic. Okay, this is Christmassy. It doesn't have, meth lab instructions. Let's see. Whoops. Don't mind that. Don't mind that! Yeah, this is fine. It's not edgy. It's not really particularly funny, but it's a ROM hack. It's Princess Toadstool. So I'm gonna go down one of these pipes, and it's gonna tell you how to access the dark web and buy drugs directly to your house. Don't let the cute exterior fool you. Okay, so there's that. Yeah, it's fine. Again, it's presents. It's Mario 3, you can't go wrong. All right. I'm going to move on. Next question to, how about Christmas Woodman? I'm going to stick in the ROM hack section for a little bit. I'm going to do Christmas Woodman. This is something I think would be good. Well, I can't read that, so I'm going to assume it's good. Mom, I watched Vine Sauce and it told me how to make meth. Fucking respawning enemies, please. That was quick. Jesus. It's a very fast ROM hack. Powers, so I'll be utilizing rewinds here. You would think I would know how to defeat Woodman. I mean, I just watched the show. Wow. Woodman, please. No, please. Please. What, is there no way around this? I think it's too late. I think I fucked up too hard. Alright, well, I don't care anymore. You know, I really want to try that Mario 64 thing. Whoever said they emailed me, you didn't actually email me. You probably emailed, like, Vinesnoss. Because I don't got it. We'll come back to the ROM hacks in a little bit, okay? We're gonna go back to the indie games. This is Christmas time. RTC 3.0 when testing, okay. That didn't work for me, but I'll try it again. Let's see, what is this? Christmas time Beebles. And it's not showing up. You don't see that, do you? Oh, here we go. Oh, the Beatles. Well, that's funny. I just streamed Hard Day's Night today. As you well know, today's Christmas. Hey, hey! Yes. This year, we'll be sure to make tonight, we'll make sure to make tonight will be a bash. I can read. Yeah, if George ever gets back. Where's the man at? Sorry I'm late, fellas. Welcome home, George. Where you been, huh? Been out all day. I'm worn. Haven't had a single chance for a bite, so I stopped by a shop to get myself a few biscuits. I'm well to have something to eat. Sure. We're all here, so let's get things started, yeah? I've set up the lights and the decorations, I'm waiting on the cook. Wow, gone the full mile, eh? Nothing above the usual. Now, the only thing left to do is ring the baker. Can't decide what kind of cake to order up. Oh, it's a hard decision, you know. Doesn't really matter, mate. Just order any one of them. The cake is the grand finale of the meal, Johnny. The first line that separates tonight from disaster. It's me, Yakko, from the Animaniacs. You want to ruin this entire night, mate? I don't care, honestly. Don't care. Yeah, it doesn't matter, mate. You'd rather just eat nothing for dessert then, Lennon. Imagine how drab that would be. You're making this a bigger than it has to be. Well, you're bigger than you have to be. Like, bigger than Jesus.
Guys, please don't go starting a punch up. This is Christmas, man. Okay, just get on and order it. We need time to properly pick the right one, Lennon. Can't just willy-nilly pick any one thing and think it'll work out. What the fuck is this game? It's late. Come on, hurry up. Obviously, you don't know what makes a proper Christmas. I'm saying we should actually start this Christmas. Lennon, I swear! Paul, you knocked down my biscuits. I need to sit out for a while. Get your act straight. Oh, George. Great. Look what you made me do. Think I control where you swing your arms? You're not pinning this on me now, Lennon. Ugh, later. Fine, run away. Don't care.
Guys.
Out of here.
Oh no. Everyone's left.
Ringo's friends have met a disagreement. Help Ringo cheer them up. Click around the room to examine and move across the house. Okay.
George's snacks got all on the floor. Guess I'll pick them up.
Would you like to go to the practice room?
There's George. Hello, George.
Hey, Rings.
Offer him cookies.
Hey, got these for you.
You picked up me biscuits.
Trying to send Vinny. I don't have a Hotmail account. 56 bagels. I don't know what email address you're trying to get. I don't know where you're getting that.
Yeah.
Shame they had to be wasted like that.
Yeah.
Thanks for picking those up. I don't see much use in them now. Besides, this isn't the problem here. I think I need to get away for a while.
Well, see you around. I don't think he'll be back for tonight.
Ringo's trying so hard. Put dialogue here. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. This game looks finished. It's broke. It's done. I can't click anything. Oh, my sweet lord. My sweet lord. I believe that was a lyric from I Am the Walrus, if I'm not mistaken. I'm just gonna move on. I'm just gonna move on, ruining Christmas every moment. This one's Silent Santa 3. Let's just assume that Ringo.
This is the third sequel of the Silent Santa. Thank you for being.
Let's just assume that Ringo saved Christmas. Shall we?
In the first Silent Santa, you felt like Santa brings presents for people. The second
Holy
Santa
wall of text.
Pleasures, like Santa's magic flying sledges with his Elvis that helps you bring presents into the Christmas town. Last, but not the last, in the third sequel, you will experience Santa's magic worship.
I don't know what's happening.
Imagine.
That's good. That's good. I feel like there's an attempt at a greater story. Oh, is that the Santa with the condom hat in the background? You see that? In this fabric is created every toy that you ever get at your home. Create whatever you want and share it in the town with your friends. Let's just enter to town. Huh. Interesting.
Ho ho ho, welcome to the Saint Wally. Here you are able to meet your friends or new people. Invite them to an incredible adventure in this town and complete all available tasks.
Wow.
You will have a lot of fun out here. Enjoy the game and Merry Christmas. Oh, and I almost forgot.
I thought this was Silent Santa.
Informed about the game controls. Please, Get back to the menu and choose a fabric option to learn the basics.
My nickname is Youngus. It's an online game? I don't like that. Do you see that? That pinch that I can do? Christmas music. You will enjoy yourself here, they said. This is fascinating in some ways. I mean, it doesn't appear that you can, like, do anything. I mean, you will have a lot of fun here, yes, but... This is kind of, you know, just one of those lonely Christmases. Here it is, everyone. This is my Christmas. It's kind of like an allegory for spending Christmas alone. I mean, it looks good. I'm going to disconnect. Back to menu. I didn't expect to do the online mode. Let me try to enter to fabric. Silent Santa that's good. I can do stuff now. Get to make all my own stuff. Wow, that's an amazing grip you got there, Santa. Press E to start printing your toy construction. Huh. I feel like this would be a better VR game. It's very limited. I did it. I made a toy. Toy will be recycled. That's a shame. Goodbye, toy. Here we go. Now this is what I want. I want a pre-made toy. Daksu. So, I think what this is, and this is actually kind of fascinating to me. It's shitty. It's like a Tommy Wiseau game. But you get to make toys, and then you get to bring them online with you. And show people the toys you've made. I think. Oh, there's a secret here. Never mind, it's not a secret. That's the jingle bell. That's the- Holy shit. Is that Mrs. Claus? Who the fuck is that? Is that Santa? Through the glass? Why is Santa all fucked up? Look, I thought I was Santa. Maybe I'm an elf. Or maybe there's some kind of, like, deep subplot. That appears to be an elf. And that appears to be a Santa who just got, like, maximum sexual pleasure. And is in a state of bliss. And can't move post-nut. I'm sorry to do that to you on Christmas. You don't need to be thinking about Santa Claus post-nut. But this is Vine Sauce, and you have to agree to stupidity when you join the stream. And failure. Lots of that, too. I don't really... You know, the execution is terrible, but it's a cool idea for a game. It's the last Jedi of Christmas. Christmas games. Guess I'll try to build one more toy. This is a boat. Okay, so you get to move things around, but then you don't get to actually place them. You know? Like, you can... It's very confusing. It's very, very confusing. But... So I get to make a light. Like, none of these spots are available to be, you know... Like, I can't actually put them down anywhere. Man. I'm not even gonna go into the help section because it would probably be another 30 minutes of our lives, but... Again, cool idea, very sloppy. Very counterintuitive. Or at least it feels that way. But... It's the most Christmassy game of the night. Get some music. Thought that would be a fun thing to do. F1 equals help. The reason I say this is sloppy without having to even touch the help, and again, you may disagree with this, but like, you can't even, like, it doesn't even make sense just by looking at it. Like, too much going on here. Like, select drop structure. Okay, hang on a minute. Hang on, something's happening. Hang on. I found a way to change the camera. Still ass. I mean, you can't say I'm not giving it a decent attempt. Really, really wanted to make my own toy, but the game just kind of wants me to suffer instead.
You have chosen a really hard work, Mikey, huh? But first,
there we go.
You need to learn how to move with your editing command. To move in any direction, use middle mouse
button. This'll help.
Or mouse scroll wheel to zoom. That is all for the basics. It is really easy, I know. Now let's move to the more advanced part. Now you will see what's the hell. In the first place, you have to choose your toy collection.
Ah, it's so obvious now.
It's up to you if your choice will be sea, land, or air collection. You have to choose your toys route. You have four routes available, so please quickly choose one of the routes. Now this is the final and most important part.
It's so easy!
Main toy editor. This is true hell, my friend. Let it snow. There you can see your main road on the funny white stick. You are also able to move in the palette and white stick that you are using. When you want to resize your object, just press the white stick and use a middle mouse wheel so you can easily resize your road. The back parts on your road. Click on some parts and move it to your cursor on the main road object. If you want to drop or collect part, just click with the left mouse button.
I feel stupid. I'm gonna stop now, cause there's only
you have chosen a really hard work, my dear. First,
huh?
You need to learn how to move with your editor camera.
Oh my God! Stop.
In any direction.
Holy shit! Let me exit this. I can't exit now. I'm stuck.
All four basics. It is really easy, I know. Now let's move to the more advanced part.
Is it easy?
What's the hell?
Oh yeah! Look at that.
In the first place.
That thing was in the wrong spot.
From the
Look, I'm making a toy.
It's up to you if your choice will be seen.
The fucking base was in the wrong spot. It was in an error zone.
Your toys route.
Okay, but the mouse isn't letting me, like...
Quickly, is one of the rules. And now, this is the final.
Oh, everything hurts. Oh god, this is like playing six games in one. My mouse isn't lining up with the light. I can't place the parts properly anymore. Holy shit. Please.
To move the power and white stick that you are using. When you want to resize your object, just flip the white stick and use a middle mouse.
No. So you can No, exit. I've had enough Christmas music. I can't deal with Christmas music. I can't deal with the voice. Quit to desktop. Oh god. Alright, that was Christmas, Silent Santa. The game with the most voice acting of the night. Death Ray Santa is next. Again. Oh, God. Again, I gave the game a lot of credit for trying. It was a very cool idea, and I wanted to see it through a little bit, but it was just very, very, very difficult. Here we go. This is Death Ray Santa. And it's Geometry Wars, but Santa Claus version. This is almost as lazy as all those run games on the Android. Almost. Not quite. Got some wubs, some Christmas wubs. Man. This is a very specific... You know, if we aren't there yet, very soon we're gonna be looking back to this. Like, this music. This, like, look. And we're just gonna be like, really? What was the popular drug? What was the designer drug of that time period? Speaking of designer drugs, do you guys want to learn how to make meth? Because I got a video game that can teach you how to do that. That's Death Ray Santa. God. Christmas Satellite. I'm going to do... Since Christmas is almost over in various parts of the world, and because I'm feeling more and more dead on the inside as we continue, I'm going to try to do all the Christmas games first. Or at least get to them now. And then we can do more of the other stuff a little bit later, right? I think that'll work best. So, Christmas Satellite. Huh. Embark on a wild adventure. I have no idea what to expect. There's a story here. Someone in chat just said this looks like it might be competent. Careful what you wish for. So, how about that story? Moving forward builds up speed. If you jump while fully crouched, you will do a big jump. I wouldn't say it's shit just yet. A little rough around the edges. Okay, I have to read the advice again. If you jump while fully crouched, you'll perform a big jump. still not enough. Oh, now, no, oh, no, 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 oh, big jump, big jump. I think this is an attempt at Christmas parkour. So not only did we get Christmas wubs, but now we're getting Christmas parkour. Oh, man. Hold right click to lock onto enemies. We've got enemies now. Aside from the candy canes, I haven't really seen a whole lot of connection. Really very, faux Christmas. The button that opens this door is in your inventory. Press tab. Oh, okay. That's the thing. You get to press tab to open doors. Okay, this is a little cool. It's a gun that inverts gravity? Huh. How about that? This game just continually surprises me. And yet again, I have no idea what it has to do with Christmas. Wow. Music isn't terrible. Again, I'm not getting Christmas vibes from any of this aside from the candy cane. It's like just candy cane. It's not a bad game, I guess. It's pretty okay. It started out like kind of bland and then it got and then I got a gravity gun of sorts. Ow. Just trying to be fair. I want to give credit where credit's due. This isn't a game I wouldn't want to play through this game all the way through. But it's fine. All right, let's see. Maybe gotta go through here. There we go. The happy Lenny-faced gun. Cuphead, great.
Santa?
Oh, don't be silly, ho ho. Santa ain't real. Name's Mixmaster Nick, your DJ Holiday, your voice of December. Ho ho. I play what? All the classics while family and friends gather together for a most jolly day. Ho ho. I don't deal presents, I dish out jingle jangles. Ho ho. Or at least I would. Had not for the fact that my equipment had been tampered with. Ho ho. I know you fools didn't do it. I brought you here.
What? Brought us here?
Yeah. That crazy dude holding you as a technician. Ho. A repairman. Ho ho.
Ho. Ho, can't really hear me. I'm a DJ.
I jacked up my means of broadcasting across the space waves. A little doohickey named Christmas Satellite. If its parts aren't found and put together in time, then no Christmas music for anyone in space. Ho, ho.
No Christmas music?
Yeah, ho, ho. None of that. You dudes gotta help me out. Find those satellite parts, ho, ho. And maybe the fool who did this while you at it. I got something that'll help you on your mission here, ho, ho. A little stocking stuffer, if you will. Ho, ho, it be my mixtape. Give it a listen, and let me know what you feel about it, ho, ho. The night's still young. Find those parts of the satellite and bring the jolly back. Peace. Ho, ho.
He had to end with the ho, ho, of course. So this is all about, like, you gotta get the mixtape of Christmas. I just wish the sound mixing was a little bit better, but yeah, this went from having nothing to do with Christmas to having everything to do with Christmas. Does that mean I'm dead now? It's like fucking Mario Galaxy. I mean, it's kind of insane in a good way. Like, it's kind of cool. It's inventive and strange. I don't really care for the gameplay very much, even though I do like the main gimmick. But it's pretty good. Look at that. It's like Mario Galaxy-esque. Did I win? There was a worm under the candy cane. The worm Frasier introduces himself and reveals that he has a satellite part. He is willing to trade you for 150 candy canes. Okay. There he is. There's Frasier the candy cane worm. So confused. Oh yeah, then there's the combat system. Which is like that. I guess. Hope, hope. So, yeah, I guess collect the candy canes, bring it back to, Lawrence the Worm. I already forgot what the worm's name is. I have the memory of a worm. Let's go! Nothing says Christmas like being screamed at by your music. I see a potential new main character. I see a gingerbread man. Here we go. New character! On your travels, you see an interesting gingerbread man. The second you get close, he starts freaking out and makes a mad dash to the top of the mountain. Looks like a race to the top. Better get moving. Wait, really? It's like Koopa speedrunning. Sorry, Koopa free running. Okay. kind of fucked that one up a little bit. I cheated. My honor is gone.
You must conquer the holy mountain.
I can't believe I'm still playing this. This turned out to be not so bad. It's a game I would actually kind of recommend if you're interested in what you're looking at. Maybe give it a try. See if you like it. I'm gonna stop playing it for now, but that's Christmas Satellite. Just an utterly bizarre, strange game that turned out to be pretty good. Who would have thought? This is Christmas Time Heroes. I want a Switch version. Merry Christmas, Dingle. Oh! Christmas Time Heroes. Yeah, it's a little anime. Let's see. Indigo Sun. I wonder if this is going to be anything like Mega Man. The Great Lord Sled is looking for new recruits. How's that for a name? Your friends were too weak, but you, we will find you very useful. That's what they all say before we give them the red nose. Yeah, it's Mega Man, all right. The Great Lord Sled. It's kind of like Mischief Makers-ish. Wait, can I do wall jumping? What did I miss? Oh, right. Yeah, you can do that while you're in the air. This is Cuphead. Memories of Cuphead. You have to press down and jump. Hang on a minute. No. I didn't start. I'm not a game journalist just yet. I didn't graduate to game journalism. If only I had another 4 or 5 minutes on that section. Warrior we told you about, sir. Season's greetings, stranger. I'm Donner, the leader of the Faunful. Indigo Sun at your service. I'm coordinating with Santa's reindeer. Holy shit. You wish for me to rekindle your spirit. Because of your willingness to help, we have just enough spirit to open this portal. By completing missions for us, you'll lift the spirit even higher. So it's all about getting into the Christmas spirit so you can open portals. Of course, I mean, I got it. It's all right. It's not bad. Again, another, like, competent game in its own way. If utterly bizarre and a strange combination of styles and ideas. It's like Mega Man Christmas anime. Okay.
Come on!
There we go. Press Q to heal. Oh, you can use your energy to heal. Okay. Whatever. Like I said, there's a lot more to get to, so I don't think I'm gonna spend too much time on this or any one particular game, unless it's, like, amazing. I think Mario's game, the Mario ROM hack, is probably gonna be great. But I'm gonna move on. Christmas Time Heroes. That's what that was. Again, I'm gonna go through all the, I think those are all the Christmas games. Let's see. 56 Bagels sent me something. I might be able to use it to stream Mayro. Let's see. That would be great. Okay, it's a Project 64, but I guess the version of Project 64 I have just wasn't working. It was crashing, and I was trying to change some of the settings, and it's crashing. So if this works, I will be very happy.
It's me, Mario.
It works. Thanks, 56 Bagels. You've saved Christmas.
You have saved Christmas.
No Christmas music? I can't make the screen bigger. Okay, it's fine. So, again, this is Mario 64 Operation Christmas.
Wahoo! Let's go.
Let's see. Hey, this isn't very Christmassy. Uh-oh. Control issues. I can't talk to the bomb. Oh, here we go. We decided not to celebrate Christmas and go on a vacation instead. Being free from all the Christmas stress is awesome. It's Christmas in Florida. That's what it is. So much warmer over here than at home. I'll never stay home for Christmas again. Open my gift. It's devious to put a bunch of gifts around and not let me open them. So where was that lighthouse? Over there. There are so many good Mario 64 ROM hacks. Again, you could probably end up being a streamer that streams only Mario 64 ROM hacks and still have more to do. Like, that could be your niche. Problem is, Nintendo kind of busted my balls about ROM hacks a while back, so I've been a little bit hesitant with stuff like this. But I'll say this. I probably wouldn't go too much into them anyway, because they're very, very detailed and long. Like, most of the really good ROM hacks are made by, Kaze Emanuar, which I've streamed some of his stuff before. He makes incredible stuff. And it's usually, like, full-length games, and if not, then it's Fidget Spinner 64. Which is fine. Then there's Mario Maker 64. Shoutouts to Pimple Flips. Who's that? I know Simple Flips. Oh, I'm so upset that I don't have Cappy or Flood. Where's the... There it is. Oh, jeez. Oh my god. This is the default camera? How the fuck is- How the fuck is that good for that? God damn it. Vinny, I ate real goose meat for Christmas. How do you feel about that? I don't know how I feel about that. I didn't know goose was a thing. I had no idea that people would eat that thing. Like, I've heard of people eating all kinds of different bird, but not goose. I mean, I know what a goose is. You know, they're motherfuckers, they shit on baseball fields, they're, loud, they're annoying. What else? Oh man, I could go on. Again, Cappy, I need you. I'll try one more time. Again, in a weird twist of fate, what I thought was going to be the most Christmassy of all the games tonight turned out to be not Christmas. I'm sure it gets Christmassy later. Yeah, the ROM hack side of things is really showing, because I can't figure out how to fucking make the camera good. Help. There's Christmas stuff, but I would stay away from the beach. Alright. Just gonna reset it.
Mario.
Alright, so you have this whole area, which is snowy and Christmassy. Maybe there's more stuff over here that I don't know about. Nothing. Never mind. There's only the beach. There's only the one beach level, but stay out of the water. Okay. That's what you mean? Alright, well, it wants me to get to the lighthouse, but I don't really want to go up there because it's kind of a nightmare. And the camera is just, like, making me miserable. So I'm gonna stop that, and I'm gonna go explore a little bit. Alright, never mind exploring. Camera's raw. It's rotten! Oh god. Oh, okay, so you have to do the Mario camera. Yeah. You have no choice but to do distant Mario camera. This is interesting. It was interesting until I went through it, and then it just became strange. Fuck. Let's see what the camera looks like here. Oh. Yeah. Yep. Not good. Oh man, Merry Christmas. Yeah, I'm having some real difficulty playing this. I think it's... I don't know if it's Mario Odyssey, or if it's the emulator, or if it's my controller, or if it's just me sucking. When I say Mario Odyssey, I mean I just got used to Odyssey. Well... whatever the case, I'm gonna switch games in... 5 seconds. Three. Two. Fun. I'm sure there's some more cool stuff in there. I think it could be a good game. And I'm sure I missed a lot of good stuff. I'm gonna pass on Operation Christmas. Yeah. Let's go back to the ROM hacks for a little bit since we're in the region. And I'm gonna show you. Hang on. Ice cream. Now I'm afraid. Ice cream. Oh, it's just ice cream. I thought it was gonna be something horrendous. I thought it was gonna be some kind of like snuff film. It's just ice cream. I don't know what I was expecting. Oh, fucking hell. It's so, yeah. Instead of Donkey Kong, we get a non-animated, realistic ice cream. And that's really... that's how you know you scraped the bottom of the ice cream barrel. Why did ice cream kidnap someone? I guess the question is, why did ice cream not kidnap someone? What reason would ice cream have to restrain? Super Mario Starlight Remix. Okay. This looks kind of cool. Here on the Starlight Islands, Mario discovers that Bowser and his 7 bratty children are up to no good again. Always. And again, if you listen to the song I played earlier, you should watch the Super Mario World Super Show. Not the Super Show, but just the Super Mario World Show. It's really good. Because there's always a musical number. I would recommend it. Apollo City? Welcome, Mario. You couldn't have come at a better time. Bowser has abducted King Apollo and his 6 retainers. You must save them. Good. I feel like every time I start a Mario game, I have to have a death like that. Right from the beginning. pretty competent ROM hack. And I already missed something cool. Okay, so this may suffer from what I call ROM hack difficulty. So far it's obviously not too bad. But one of the problems I have with ROM hacks, and I've always had, is that when you go to play like a Zelda 2 ROM hack or a Super Metroid ROM hack or even Castlevania, anything, and Mario too, when it's one person developing a mod for a game and making levels, sometimes that tends to turn into, I have to make it super difficult because I can beat my levels very easily. So they end up like jacking up the difficulty, which is good for like, you know, people who are looking for like a real challenge. Experts, perhaps. But there are times when the ROM hack difficulty gets so frustrating that I just don't want to continue playing them. I've played really good ones. I've played balanced ones. Southbird made one called Mario 3 Mix. I thought that was like a really good difficulty curve. Like, it doesn't start with the kitchen sink right away. It kind of gradually works up to the kitchen sink. Which is really all I'm asking. I don't mind the difficulty as long as it ramps up slowly. But then there's Kaizo, which just starts off, go fuck yourself. Then ends up at go fuck yourself. Oh, nice corruptions. And then, you know, all along the way is continually go fuck yourself. Kaizo does not take prisoners. Some interesting red block coins. The fuck is this? Oh. Mario Maker had some, yeah, Mario Maker was one of those kinds of things where it turned into who can make the hardest level. Sometimes they felt like actual, like, difficult Nintendo levels, and that's a good thing. I love the stories or the videos of the people that make a level that they can't beat, and it takes them like 10 to 20,000 tries. And then they finally beat it and upload it, and then no one ever beats their level. Some say people are still trying to this very day. They're now shy people. The fuck is this level? Oh, that's supposed to be like a design. That's a decoration in a palace. I get it. I get the picture. Underwears. Sorry, Yoshi. Reign of Koopa 1. So that was cool. That was fine. I've played a lot of cool Mario World ROM hacks, and that one, I would say, is pretty competent. And it didn't feel like it had that shitty difficulty problem I was talking about. It actually just kind of felt like a good game. So some of these are good. There's more, like, there's some trash and some weird ones. But this is in the good category. Okay, first thing I'm gonna say is, this is a fucking strange style for a Mario ROM hack on the NES. The Koopas are upright. Inexplicably. But, you know what? This looks pretty good. Mario's face is a little fucked up. But he's been eating a lot more pizza than usual. And he gets stung by a bee on the nose. And he's also post-coitus. But yeah, this is a Mario 1 mod, it seems. So it's relatively... Yeah, it is Mario 1, yes, for sure. It controls like Mario 1. But it's colorful. And there's an endless supply of games like this, too. Which is why Mario Maker was such a good idea. Like, okay, Nintendo wants to take down fan games and shit. I don't agree. However... get in on the action. Make something better. Mario Maker was a really, really good, you know... it was a good competitor. And it was a lot of fun, and... people played that, and for a while people weren't making ROM hacks, and then they sponsored, like, tournaments with Mario Maker. I would love to see, like, a very simple Zelda Maker, as I've talked about. I wouldn't mind a Mario Maker port or a Mario Maker 2 on the Switch. So, you know, if you're pissed about people making ROM hacks, Nintendo, do exactly what you did, but do more of it. Make your own. Or, give us the tools, man. I was a little bit disappointed with Mario Maker, because it was a little more limited than some of the modding tools. But it was still pretty damn good for what it was, and I made a lot of levels. I got bored of it eventually, but for a while there, it was a lot of fun. Mario Kart Maker? Well, I mean, I've always said that the evolution of Mario Party and Mario Kart would be a board editor and a course editor, respectively. I would love that. So again, just a decent game. It's called Reign of the Koopa. You know what? I'll go through. I'm gonna save a Toad. I'm gonna rewind and stuff, but I'm gonna save a Toad. Just... obviously... not giving too many fucks here. Mario's hat annoys me. This version of Mario. Oh my god. What am I doing? Oh, that Mario 1 physics! Yes! So Nintendo just released the Versus Mario Brothers, which is like kind of a... I think it was an arcade version of Mario Brothers or something like that. I don't know. Now that 2017 is... what the fu- oh, it's a Koopa Kid. Alright. Now that 2017's over, we still don't have a decent online plan for the Switch. And we still don't have the Virtual Console. I know there's a rumored Nintendo Direct for January. It would be really great to see what they're doing with their online infrastructure and their Virtual Console stuff. Like, this year... oh, what? Oh my god. No way! Paid online might be coming in autumn 2018. Self-aware, at least. I love the attempt at Sonic music on the SNES. Some people like me somewhere. I am sad now. That's fascinating. Did I just turn into fucking Super Saiyan Sonic? Fuck. Oh, I'm in a two-player game right now. One-player game. Act 1. Baby Sonic. Let's see how fast Sonic will actually go. I don't have the rewind. Oh well. It's still Mario on the world map though. I mean, or Luigi. So, you know, that's just... Ignore that. Ignore that. It's fine. Turns out you can't go very fast in this. Hey, the Sonic theme actually sounds pretty decent in the Super Mario World sound palette. Sound font. So what if I just play through this whole thing, and then I started acting like I've played through a full Sonic game? Oh, that's kind of cool, actually. Huh. I like that. Oh, I've totally played through a full Sonic game by myself, guys. I played Super Mario Sonic World. I know exactly about Sonic. I know how it works. I know all the lore. I got everything. Luckily, I already played my Sonic game for the year. That's over. Sonic 3, done. Let's go straight to the weird bootlegs now. That's incredibly loud. That's not just regular loud. This is Rockman X4 on the Game Boy Color. Oh, it looks terrible. And this is in weird bootlegs. Grenade Man? What? Oh god, it's awful. Pellets. Oh, the pellets are so slow and shitty. Who's the main protagonist in Sonic? It's... Knuckles. So yeah, I think this is, if it's in the bootleg category, maybe these aren't, like, ROM hacks by fans, but, like, actual bootlegs? But I'm not sure. No, we all know that the main Sonic villain is Wario. So I had the Mega Man Game Boy games. And they were semi-competent. They weren't completely terrible. They did not compare to the NES versions because they were slower and kind of shittier. Mega Man's run cycle in this. It's almost as bad as the Mega Man 11 run cycle. Look at that animation. What the fuck? It's like he's skiing. Or sorry. Skating. Ice skating. Spider-Man 3 movie version. I don't know, again, I'm not really sure where Alizarin got these, but... What the fuck? Ben Parker. A normal high school student. After the bite from a radiant spider, he had various superpower, walking on the wall and ceiling, give off cobweb. Apparently this is Pokemon pinball music. It makes it even better. At the beginning, Parker only used his power to earn private pocket money. But when his beloved uncle murdered by the bad guys, he promised he would attack the crime depend on. I didn't press any buttons. Norman Osborn, the famous scientist, his classmates, Vater, managed a chemical applying company. Oh, this is great. This is fucking great. This is like that bootleg toy with the weird story on the back. In one experiment, Norman something breathed in nerve gas, emerged the evil characteristics, became the Green Goblin hated by everyone, with the purpose of controlling the whole world. He made Greg Goblin, huh? Spider-Man, the hero, with the heart protecting justice, would take steps to sentence Green Goblin's crime. So broke the war between fair and evil. That's an interesting way to say that. I thought it was good and evil, but fair and evil makes sense. This does not sound like heroic Spider-Man music. Well, look how long it takes to go back to the story. About 5 seconds? That's very confusing. Oh my god, really? More? Hidden behind the prosperous city, diversified damned desires. The Spider-Man had the overwhelming power. He couldn't completely secure damning desires. Brekfa. Oh man. El Devo. Akfa. Just like fucking kill that person? Like, what are tigers doing in New York City? Oh, this is a steaming pile of fucking hot trash. Spider-Man's arms are white, but the rest of him is fairly accurate. Look at that web shot. That's like a hump. It's like an air hump into a thrust. Barrett would approve. And it's so slow. It's so slow. It's like beating up like fucking pigeons. I don't get how fair and evil has anything to do with this when I'm destroying, like, fucking, like, cats and pigeons. I mean, obviously this guy's a bad guy, because he's here. I don't know his history, I don't know, like, his, you know... I don't care, I've already deemed him an undesirable, apparently, and he has to go, just because he's here. Like, I haven't seen any of these people do any crimes. Alright, that dude did a crime. He threw a knife at me. And he's smoking pot. Or maybe just a cigarette. That's okay. Spider-Man is the ultimate judge of fair and evil. If you're smoking a doobie, you are sentenced to death. Found my one weakness, escaping my cobweb. Cobweb. Oh shit, that's definitely Mega Man assets down there. Those spikes. can't believe I'm still playing this. Why am I still playing this? Vinny, 100% of these sounds are Pokemon Pinball. What is this, dude? What is that? Oh, it's just a motorcyclist. I thought it was like a lizard. I don't want to kill the dog. The dog is nice. God damn it. There's zero benefit to killing dudes. Oh, shit. Alright, well that was... that was astoundingly amazing. This is Super Mario World 7. I wonder how grand this game is gonna be. So we've had 7 of them, huh? It's been a whole 7. That's Adventure Island. Is that a Sonic tree? The fuck is this weird jumble of assets? It's like Mario World assets and Sonic assets. That's a Goomba. Oh, and it's a Mario game where you can't jump on Goombas. Fucking great. Great game! That is a fucking great game template to steal from Mario. A game where you can't actually jump on... these Goombas are like deformed. Someone put like cyanide or strychnine in the water supply. Bowser's like factory. They don't give a shit. They're just dumping all their fucking waste into the water. Their own Goombas are suffering. Kind of reminds me that the Mario Land 2 got a full color hack. So you remember how I played Mario Land 2 like 9 or 10 months ago? And it was in shitty color. It didn't look so good. Well, now it's perfect. Kind of wish I held off. It looks really nice now. Maybe I'll stream it again one day. Someone in chat said, 1-2 bottomless pit, exactly where this game should go. Thanks. I always love that when I run out of things to say, I can just relay chat messages. It's as lazy a stream strategy as this game is a Mario, attempted Mario game. And yes, that was Yoshi. I know the joke has been made before. In previous Adventure Island slash Mario hacks. But that was Yoshi! He looks a little different. I told you, the strychnine in the water supply is a little bit... you know... like, the descaling plant is just dumping, like, diseased blood back into Koopa Lake. Here, have Crash 2 advanced. Serene life of people. Is in this fine cosmos. Oh, I can't deal with English, man. It gets me every time. There is an unknown object in the mysterious space to surround the Earth high speed to exercise to come over. Oh, this has got to be the same developer as Spider-Man. Uka, I do not know to how I still take you nearby. You disappointed me too many times. Cortex says, forgives me. I wasted so many years to try to conquer those stupid people. Trust me. I have a plan for a resident of the weak and small people on Earth. I think that's supposed to be Cortex in the bottom left there. I'm coming. No, please. No, can we go back? I don't want to know that, Cortex. Finally, mankind of my planet have already completed. He said he was coming. That kind will admit for my super intelligence. Oh, I'm dying. I have tears in my eyes. Your god, I am. I am your ruler. Ha, finally I won. And now, Mo-1 can obstruct me. I'm fucking done. I can't. Holy shit. This is a post-nut story now. Crash, alter evil to be straight. Go to rescue. Will so soon cosmos that suffer hardship in of living to work properly. Oh, this is really fucking bad English. Like the Spider-Man stuff almost made sense. I'm really struggling with this one. ...2003, Crash 2, Huge Adventure. I want to know where this game was sold. I'm also a fan of how the title screen started with, a screensaver. Well, I mean... What was that? Crash is looking a little sick. The pants are very long, too. But what is killing Crash? Like a little, like... pony mouse puppy... thing. Never mind, I defeated my greatest foe. I don't think I need to tell you guys this, but it plays like fucking dog shit. I was almost gonna give it credit because, it almost feels like it could be a Crash Bandicoot game with the spin attack, but it's so sluggish and terrible and the hitboxes are bad and... I mean, come on, I didn't need to actually tell you that, right? Game over, Crash is dead. Sonic Adventure 8. No. Please. Sonic Italian. Oh no. Oh, fucking end me now. Vinny, this is Tasmania, is it? Is this just a reskinned other game? Wow, what a surprise. The music is like piercing my skull. Yeah, it's barely playable. Sonic gets stuck. Any of the fluid kind of like platforming you expect from a Sonic game... well... at least fast platforming. At least. Depending on the game. Depending on which game you're playing. But any of that is like just thrown out the fucking window because Sonic gets stuck on the ground! Wow, okay, you can actually do a Sonic trademark thing. And you can also die. Yeah, why is Sonic red? I think this is some kind of Knuckles Sonic hybrid. There you go, that's maximum speed. You just witnessed it. Harry Boy, the secret X of the Chamber of the Secrets. Oh no. Oh no, it's that logo. Get ready for more English! Harry Boy ignored the spirit Dobby's advice, insisted on returning the Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry that congested various dangerous terror affairs was take place in the formerly quiet campus ever and again. The beloved cat of custodian Filch especially grasped the troublemaker was hung up the torch handle on the aisle, and here were several red and large words. The riddle of the Chamber of Secrets had been show up in the wall. Oh my god. I feel like I should be drinking for this. The new student in grade one, Crab, and the school of souls has also sit down by the hand grab of sleepily leaked. Whoa. By the hand grab of steps, weakly and limply, his good friend Ron was also attacked and taked away one cryptically power. Is Hermione? No, Hermione isn't named Crab in this, right? That's a Harry Potter sprite. Harry Boy became a frog too. So everything may be a close relationship with that secret room. Harry, Ron, and Crab. What on earth was the secret hidden in the mysterious room? Who opened the door, and who cabaled all the terror affairs in the campus? What was his intent? Harry Boy, who lost the human body, began his journey to unveil the riddle. Harry Boy in the Chamber of Secrets. Just go down a pipe, just like Harry Potter would do. But I'm still a frog. Hey, wait a minute, that sprite was in the Crash game. Is this Mario Brothers? Pokemon music, Mario Brothers, Harry Potter, and I'm a frog. This is truly an inexplicable combination of nonsense. This isn't the official Super Mario Brothers port either. Or is it? Is it the deluxe version? I can't laugh anymore after last night's corruptions. I get it now. I get it. The frog was only temporary form. Once you get meat, you turn into Harry Potter! Or maybe it's not the official port, because it's like kinda trash. No, this isn't Mario Deluxe. This is like fucking hog piss. stable and solid game engine as well. What the fuck? Yeah, there's no way this is anywhere close to an official Mario Brothers port. The gameplay, it's sluggish and assified. Oh boy, oh no. I'm sorry to do this. Oh, damn it. Oh, the file name is too long. This is the Lord of the Rings, the Fellowship of the Ring. King of Ring. I have to remove King of Ring so the file name will not be too long. It's syntax. Oh god, I'm starting to get fucking PTSD from syntax. Midland world. About 5,400 years ago, Dark Lord combined the technique of the metallurgy and the magic, smelting a lot of rings with magic power. In face, he returned to Mordor stealthy, smelting most powerful ring, and with this ring's magic power to control the control and suppress the other rings and to establish the powerful Dark Kingdom. Why is it going so fast? Midland world. Before the end of the second century. Century! The King of Spirit Gilgalad and the Numenor's King Elendil, hand in hand, composed the League of the Human and the Spite. Sorry, Sprite. After the Flaming War, Dark Lord failed finally. Failed. F-A-I-L-D, the inheritor of the Elendil, used the fragments of the Saint Sword slashed. Wait, slashed? The Dark Lord's finger and occupied the ring? Or cuccupied the ring? I can't tell. The ring spread from place to place. Surprise appeared in very fond, delicious foods. What?! Surprise appeared in very fond of delicious foods and easy life. Life's race hobbits. Frodo Baggins, who inherit the relative's property in the strange situation, the inherit of responsibility for world saving, and so be the target that the good guys and the bad guys that to fight for. I can't. King of Ring. Who am I playing as? I'm from Frodo. I have Sting already. Only profoundest philosopher can pass this place. Well, shit. So this is, yeah, that's Hobbiton. The bottom right there, there's a Shire. Okay. Here's the Field of Middle-earth. And what game is this ripping off? Look at that shit. Look at that attack. My god. Just like Frodo would do. Speaking of Lord of the Rings, I'm kind of now tempted to buy the Lord of the Rings Blu-ray. Is that a Pokemon? I don't remember Frodo killing dogs. In the movies. and pirates. That lunge attack is dangerous. I would not recommend the lunge attack. What's the name of the town that they get to first? With the prancing pony? Is that the name of it? The Green Dragon or something? Felch? Is that the name of the town? The first Lord of the Rings town? Bree. Oh, yes, Bree. Well, here it is.
I'm glad to see you. Now, follow me.
There's Gandalf. I don't have a choice. And immediately we've gone to Saruman's tower. Orthanc. Long time no see, my friend. This time, I come to hear is... What? I come to hear is want to know something about the ring. The ring. How should we deal with the ring? Gandalf the Grey feature is no more controlled by us. Now we should go to help. Now we should go to go, should to go and seek help from Dark Lord. Give me the ring. We can start a whole new world to get her. You are not my best friend anymore. Then I will need to attack you. I guess so. I remember this scene. It's surprisingly following the movie a little bit more closely than, say, Harry Potter Mario Brothers. I didn't realize fucking Gandalf and Saruman were best friends. But, you know, they were just part of the council, right? But yeah, this is my favorite part of the Lord of the Rings movie, when Gandalf is betrayed and then has to fight his way down through the gargoyle pit of Orthanc. That is astounding that we actually got some of the game story. My favorite part of the game's graphics are when the forest turns into a vagina. And now I'm Frodo again. Okay, now we're gonna get to the prancing pony. Oh. Oh. Aragorn killed Gandalf. Game over. Here's Mario Fighter 3. And I've played Mario Fighter before, but this is 3. Oh my god. Why is that sprite? This isn't granddad, by the way. This is granduncle. The World Warrior. Oh, I think I played this recently. Hang on a minute. I don't get to choose my character? I want to be Mario. There he is. Thanks. Yeah, I've played... I don't know if I've played... I probably have played this exact one. You can't go too far on Vine Sauce without seeing this. But, this is really quite astounding, isn't it? For newcomers, this must be quite the fucking fever dream. I guess they figured Mario wasn't tall enough, so they just stretched him out a little bit. Alright. Zookman ZX4. What is this? Game Boy Advanced? Advance. It says I'm missing the firmware for this. Configure your firmware. Strange. I'll try a backup. I've always got backups. Okay, so if it doesn't work in one, maybe it'll work in another. Visual Boy. Let's see. Yeah. Maybe. Doesn't work in Visual Boy. I'm not going to worry about it. Listen. I don't think we're missing out on a whole lot. How about Super Mario Brothers for Atari 2600? The fuck is this music? Oh, God. Why does it say mmm up top? It's like I don't like it. Smurf body with Mario head. Oh, this is based on the Smurf game? Back in my day, when the game was the game. I don't get it. I'm kind of happy. This is gonna piss some people off, but I am kind of really happy I didn't grow up with Atari as my primary gaming system. I'm happy that I started games with Nintendo. That was good. But seriously though, this game doesn't make any fucking sense. I have no idea how to play it properly. Here, have Super Simpsons. Don't have a pant, man! Wow. Bart has already consumed his pant, because there are none right now. There is zero pant. Wow. Looks like a crackhead. Straight up crackhead. Bort is fucking scary. Homer's gonna have to beat the shit out of him. Homer.
Come here, it's me, Bort, your son.
Gonna have to hit you, boy!
No, homie! He stole it from your cock! It came from your seed, homie! He was in you once! You shouldn't hit what was in you!
Alright, boy, consider yourself lucky.
I don't know. It's like I have all the voice actors here in my house. Right now, there's still a bit more. Let's see. Chow Resort Island. So these aren't necessarily bad, they're just unique indie games, basically. So I'm not going to spend too much time on these. Hey, that looks surprisingly good. I guess it's like an Animal Crossing clone-ish. But with them chows from Sonic. Play. I hate when it doesn't tell you which button to press, and you have to just press like every button on your keyboard. I have to press like G. If I have to choose, I want to be the bad boy. Hey, you there. Wait just a second.
Hey. Homer.
Again, if I was actually playing this game legit, then I would probably go through this. But I just want to walk around and explore and look at it. It's also 3 a.m. So, of course, I would recommend, you know, if I'm not giving it the attention it deserves, if it's really great and you're upset that I don't read or play the games, which, of course, someone always will be, I would invite you to play it yourself. It's called Chow Island Resort. C-H-A-O. Professor Bunga? Visually, I think the game looks great. Simple. Effective. Kind of reminds me of Animal Crossing. I think this could be something worthwhile. Which is precisely why I'm not going to be playing more of it than I played that Spider-Man game. What do you think those eggs smell like? Just asking. But why can't I go fast and collect rings? My favorite part of this game is when I, as Knuckles, get to sit on the egg. Like so. And you have to wait 36 real hours. And then it'll hatch. And based on the character you choose, it will have a hybrid look. So if you choose Sonic, it'll look half Sonic, half Chow. If you choose Knuckles, half Knuckle, half Chow. Alright, that's enough Chow Island Resort. I'm sure it's a good game. I'm sure it's cool. speaking of Sonic. Something like that actually happens in one of the Sonic games. That's actually pretty much how it works. What? That's sort of how chaos works. What? What? That's a thing? What I described a minute ago? Oh, the Sonic games are very weird sometimes. Oh, it's loud. Sonic 2 the Hedgehog HD. It's a demo. It's a demo build. Looks kind of awesome, though. Wow. I can see every pixel. It's the very definition of HD. It's 4K. 4K Sonic. And Tail. Got the Sonic. Don't let him tell you that you can't defy gravity. You can. I've seen it. I've done it. Well, yeah, it's good. I mean, it plays like Sonic 2, which I have limited experience with. However, I think it's legit. It's been in the making for years. It's a full HD remake of Sonic 2. See, I play a lot of shitty Sonic fan games, so playing a good one kind of makes me more interested in the series. You know, I've played too much garbage. You know, considering how many games I do at one time during the Sunday trash streams, I want you to consider that I've played more trash games than good games throughout my entire life. Even if that means, like, only 10 seconds per game, you know, well, actually, a couple minutes. 10 minutes, 5 minutes, whatever the case. I've played probably way more trash than I've ever played good games. It's a bitch. I would say probably even worse than James Rolfe, because James Rolfe, he does usually like one or two games. He'll cover a couple, he'll do compilations. But there are nights on this stream where I do like 50 games a night, 40, 50 games a night, even if it's only a couple minutes each. However, James Rolfe plays through the games entirely. I jump ship. So I'm not claiming that I have like any kind of medal here, because that motherfucker plays through the games in full sometimes. He'll go through an entire bad game on an NES without hacks, without cheats. Oh, this looks cool. There's that cool music. See, I mean, I know it's funny because even though I've only ever played through one Sonic game in full, which was Sonic 3, just this year, I'm well aware of Sonic through like osmosis and like, you know, watching speedruns or my friends having Genesee. But yeah, this is a really, really great remake. Corpse Box Racers. Got just a couple games left and then we can do art because we're getting real close to the end of the Lizard Crate. Corpse Box Racers. I can't even really imagine what kind of thing this will be. It's exactly what the title described it to be. So someone said, you know what would be a great idea for a video game? You put a dead body in a box and then you just have them race around a little bit. Just have them race around. Everything's locked. Wow. Well, you don't want to get out of your box. I see now. This isn't necessarily a racing game so much as it is stay in your box. Kind of like a mix of Super Monkey Ball and a racing game, I guess. Like a time trial racing game. Way more Super Monkey Ball. Oh, look at that. Careful, them textures. Them textures. Ready? Go! Fallout! Fallout! Is that Vinny playing the game again? Wow, you've attempted the same part in the same level for 2 hours straight. Get a life! And, so that's Corpse Game Racers. And this one's Pet the Pup. Hoping it's gonna load. Willbot. Pet the pup at the party. Okay. Are we... Is this Doug? Or is it just... One... Oh, fuck. I think I touched her boobies. Sorry about that. I didn't know that that's what my hand could do. I'm just kind of like... Just being very feely in general.
Well, hello, Douglas. I'm not a pup!
Oh, man. Oh, man. It's trippy shit, man. So, where's the pup? trying to like listen for the pup so I can find it and then pet it. These are boxes. Corpse box racers in there. Bark twice if you're in Amsterdam. Where the fuck is the pup? Pup, please. Definitely heard it in my right ear. I feel like the pup should be in here somewhere. Or like over this way. Right? I feel like the pup should be over here. But I see no pup. I think I saw the text for the Borfk through the window. Look. Arf! See? Shit, it's too late now, though. No! Ah! Okay, I hear Borfking. Trying to locate the Borfking through echolocation. Pup is close. Yes! Lemmy. There's the dog food, but no dog. Huh. There's a good pup. Yeah, I like this too. This is pretty good. You played this a ton in a previous stream. Really? I played this? Sure about that? Was it me, or was it some other wacky YouTuber? Person, streamer person. You know, crazy vine sauce in the morning. No, I don't recall having played this. I played a cat game. Maybe Vsauce played it. What were my radio guy names? Didn't I have some names? It was like Big Bopper and Cocksucker in the morning.
All right, welcome to Big Bopper and Cocksucker in the morning. How's your commute? Well, go fuck yourself. This isn't about you, this is about us. Big Bopper and Cocksucker in the morning. And now the news. Go fuck you.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, then there was Mitch and Mitch. Mitch and Mitch, they sound a little different. Mitch and Mitch were talking about the 30 motorist pileup on the San Fernando Expressway. 30 motorists have piled up.
They're the competition, but they're a little bit less in your face. They're not the shock jocks. They're just kind of like the news guys. You know, they're Mitch and Mitch. They give you the news. They all right. They give you that. But yeah, Big Bopper and Cocksucker in the morning. The ratings are pretty good. Better than Mitch and Mitch. Because Mitch and Mitch, they don't bring titties on the radio. Big Bopper and Cocksucker are bold enough to have topless, full nude in the studio. Now, you can't see it, but it is the theater of imagination, of course. I always wondered about that, like on the Howard Stern thing, like... I listened to Stern in the radio a little bit when I was younger, just because it was on 92.3. It was on the radio station, like, locally, you know? But I always wondered about how Howard Stern became so huge. Like, I know generally the story. You know, I've seen the movie. But to me, it's strange that some people would watch, or rather listen to a radio show because they tell you that there's a lady in there with big knockers. They just tell you about it. You get to hear nudity. And that became a huge, huge thing. Back when K-Rock was good. Well, they're attempting. 92.3 is now alternative rock. I'm trying to figure out how to get some Red Vox on there. But for 6 years, New York didn't have a contemporary rock station. And I guess we still don't, because they're just playing fucking Red Hot Chili Peppers ad nauseum on 92.3. But it's like some newer stuff, some like, you know, hipsters dressed in Civil War uniforms whistling with like a tribal drum and a bunch of oh. So there's that, but then there's also like, you know, like a lot of good 90s alternative. There's some classic rock on there, there's some Police, there's some Floyd, some Bowie. So they're trying to do like a lot of everything, and some of it's pretty good. But, you know, I just kind of use Spotify in my car now. I get to pick whatever I want to listen to, or I can leave it on a radio station on Spotify that plays music I like, but also gives me some new stuff. You know, like I'll get some like deep cuts that I've never heard before. Why is every pup in the same room so far almost? Vinny, do you not like Chili Peppers? Oh, no. I love the Chili Peppers. I think they're great. I get a little sick of them because they're overplayed. The same way I love Nirvana, and I know people give me shit because Nirvana is so mainstream. So overrated. So overrated. But you know what? In Utero is a fucking amazing album, and it's cathartic, and it's still great. But I'm sick of hearing Nirvana. I'm just sick of hearing them, as much as they, you know, influenced my growing up and my music. I mean, I was 10 years old, I was listening to Nirvana. I don't know why, I just liked it. But the Chili Peppers are kind of the same thing for me. Like, as much as I enjoy their music, I got really good at this game. As much as I enjoy Chili Peppers, they get super, super played. And it's usually the same, give it away, give it away, give it away now. Give it away now. I can't see you, I'm coming to the frog. When they have like so much better shit on like Stadium Arcadium and Californication and Blood Sugar Sex, there's so many like deep cuts and I'm just hearing get away now.
Sometimes I feel like I don't have a piggy. Sometimes I feel like Kermit the Frog.
Okay, I can't continue doing Pup Game. I gotta get going and do the art now. I do really genuinely enjoy the Chili Peppers. I know I'm kind of shitting on them, but they're in my playlist on Spotify. They're in there. Also, I updated it, my Vines Sauce playlist on Spotify, which if you Google, or rather type that in, Vine apostrophe S sauce space sauce. It's a playlist that I kind of just keep adding to. Some songs get removed, which is kind of weird, but now there's almost like, I've been working on this playlist for about a year almost, and there's like 550 songs, and it's just kind of like a good intro to the stuff that I like, and I just added a bunch of stuff to it. I feel like there is a band missing. There's a couple things, like Tool's not on Spotify, which I don't really know what the fuck they're doing. There's covers, but yeah, Tool's not on Spotify, which is a really, really bizarre thing because like fucking everyone is. Also, Another Light is still not on Spotify, which is annoying. Well, it is, but just under the wrong account. Like, why? But anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed whatever insanity this Christmas stream or vaguely related to Christmas stream was. I had a good time, and thanks for spending your Christmas with me. I have a little art to get to, maybe more than a little art. And then, of course, we can all disperse.